Hello, hello everyone. It is Jackie from Pocket of Preschool and I am so excited you guys are here tonight because tonight I am going to show you tons and tons of activities for a Veterans Day theme, but a lot of these you can use for a lot of the like patriotic holidays like 4th of July or when voting season comes around, President's Day. So I want you to tell me in the comments, what do you do for Veterans Day in your classroom? Do you guys have like an assembly? Do you do something school-wide? Do you just do things in your classroom? Or do you have you not done it in your classroom before? So kind of tell us all the things in the comments. And then I'll tell you about the things at the top. So make sure you guys are signed up for my newsletter because I have a fun freebie for you guys. And since I don't have a blog post and Facebook does not like Bitly, Google Drive links, I will send you this freebie in my newsletter, which will go out tomorrow. So make sure you're signed up for that. The link to do that is at the top. And then I think, my TpT store, the links to all of those things are up there too. So we are gonna jump right in and get started. So Veterans Day, it's kind of like, I like a, such a fun patriotic day. So I kind of went with a very patriotic theme, but yet we're gonna tailor it a lot to Veterans Day. So a lot of these things I buy a lot of these props during like 4th of July, but I'm sure you can find a lot of these at party stores right now. The one thing that is really fun to do is, you guys know I love sensory bottles. Actually, this is on my blog. You can make some patriotic sensory bottles. So this one is just red water and glue, and there's stars and glitter. So that one is really fun. And then we have a firework sensory bottle. So this one has, you can see the sparkly pipe cleaners. And then this one has baby oil inside because anytime you put anything metal in a sensory bottle, you want to use baby oil so it doesn't rust. And then sparkly pom-poms. So the details for these are on the blog. And then here is just one that is rice because I like to make sure to have dry sensory bottles too because sometimes the kids like the noise. That's calming for them. And I put little flags. So those little flags are actually the little like toothpick flags. So those are great to cut off too as counters. Let me grab one. So what you can do is buy a set of these and then cut the little toothpick off, or you can keep it on. And you can use these as fun manipulatives for counting or Play-Doh trays, anything like that. So little toothpick flags. I'm sure you can grab them like at the party store or something like that. So I have a fun Play-Doh tray for Veterans Day. I'm gonna move these out of the way. So this one has, again, red, blue, and white Play-Doh. And then I have a whole bunch of these flags because these are so fun to just stick in the cupcakes or just the Play-Doh. And then I have some star beads, which these are from Michael's. Sometimes the Dollar Tree has star beads, but I bought this pack. And I just use the red, the blue, and the white star beads. So that is fun just to put in the Play-Doh so they can make little flags. I did find some patriotic cookie cutters. This one's the USA. This one's a flag. If you don't have those, no worries. Just grab some star cookie cutters, different sizes, and you can put those in your Play-Doh tray. Those are perfect. And then I love silicone cupcake molds. I just grabbed the red and the blue ones. And then some red and blue tools. So I have this is like a Play-Doh knife, rolling pin, another Play-Doh knife, and then Play-Doh scissors. So get kids cutting with the scent, or get kids cutting Play-Doh because it's more fun to cut Play-Doh than paper. So these are from Lakeshore. So just a fun Play-Doh tray. I keep this in the art center, and what they do is they play with it. I'm sure the colors will get mixed together. And then they play with it on a tray. They use the Play-Doh to sculpt or make or create whatever they want using all of the goodies. which is also developing all those little fine motor muscles. And as they're smushing the Play-Doh, it's also developing those upper arms and shoulders, which they need the, that to be strong in order for the little fingers to be strong. So that's great. And then as they're taking it apart, and they always have to put everything back in, that's more great fine motor and working, especially like the beads, working on that pincer. You could also put pennies in your Play-Doh tray. That would be another fun thing to do. So that's the Play-Doh tray idea I have for you. Another fun idea are, I love plates. I love using, different plates for different themes, just to kind of make the learning more hands-on. I just grabbed some blue ones, some red ones, I didn't have silver where I was, so I just grabbed these, and then I want to show you some fun activities you can do with these. Obviously, you can use them for gross motor, so you can put them like in a circle, and they have to hop over them, so kind of set up an obstacle course, like a patriotic obstacle course, and they have to follow the stars and go like over or under the table or hop over the stars or through the hula hoops, but this would be fun to make a path with for Veterans Day. So, and so shiny and so fun. Or you can also write letters on them. If you can see it, it's kind of shiny. So what you would do is you would take your plates and you would line them up. And if you don't want to write on the letters, you can always just put like a big letter manipulative on it. Oh, my screen isn't liking the shininess. So I just put like A, B, C, D, all the way down the line, and then I just put out buckets of manipulatives, letter manipulatives, and then they have to sort the manipulatives and to the matching plate. And I have an uppercase and a lowercase. You can do just uppercase or just lowercase, totally up to you, whatever you guys wanna do. But it makes a gigantic alphabet line, so the kids have to grab a letter, identify it, say the sound, and then they have to find the letter, which also gets them up and moving. And we know when we get kids moving, we have less behaviors, and it just makes the activity so much more engaging. You can also do this on a table if you don't wanna do it on the floor and just kind of put them all around the edge. All right, you can also use these plates to make puzzles. So this one, I did a number puzzle. So this one has, I wrote the number 4 on it. They're shiny, so they're a little bit tricky to see. And then I just put some dots on this one. So this would, they would have to put the 4 and the 4 together. So count out the objects and put it with the numeral. And then this one has the 3. So again, just to cut them up. And all different fun ways, and you can make puzzles. You could also, so you could do these with numbers. You could do these with shapes. So like put like a square on this side and a square on that side, and they have to match the shape. If you are worried about them not being able to see the number because they're shiny, you can also always use stickers on your plates. And then you could also cut this and do a letter puzzle. So like you could just cut it in half, and then do like uppercase A and lowercase A, and then they have to match it together. Or you could do like uppercase A and find, like, I know there are sticker sets that for the letters in the alphabet, so you could put like a beginning sound right here too. So you could do puzzles for numbers, or you could make them for letters. And again, just something fun and easy. I usually find these at the Dollar Tree. Again, I think I want to say I bought these around 4th of July, but sometimes they just have these things randomly, and they might have it right now because Veterans Day is coming up. It's just so fun and sparkly. And again, I bet the party store probably has them too, like all year round. So this is just a fun cutting activity. So it's just a whole bunch of straws, and these straws, these are the ones that are like in the big pack from the Dollar Tree, and they're just striped red and blue, which is perfect. And then these are just some fun ones I found, probably Target Dollar Spot during like 4th of July. So what they do is they have to cut the straws. If you put out the cardboard straws, sometimes they can be tricky. So I also like having some plastic straws out too, just so they're easier to cut. If kiddos are struggling, like these are too tricky, then the plastic ones are great. And then what they can do is they can lace the straws and kind of give their cutting fingers a break, and they can lace it on there. And then I just have more of those star beads. So then they can also work on some hand-eye coordination and problem-solving skills, and they can lace all of the things on there. And if, I know sometimes like the stuff gets kind of expensive, you can just put it out with pipe cleaners, just like a couple of them, and they don't have to take it home as a bracelet. Like, you can just have it as the cutting activity and then put it in a baggie, and then you can use it again next year. So a fun little patriotic-ish cutting bit for Veterans Day. So I have a sensory bin for you guys. I just made it little so I could show you guys on here. So this is just, I have this on my blog, I think, and this is in the curriculum map too. But it's just some rainbow rice. Well, not rainbow, sorry. So I actually use paint to color this, but this is why I don't use paint usually, because it clumps on me. And I don't know if I'm just doing it wrong, but I have better luck with liquid watercolor. I just have some rice and I dyed it red, yellow, and white. You could also do a silver or gold. That would be really fun. And then I put in just some blue and red tools. Literally went in my drawer. What blue and red tools do I have? Grab some of those. I do like having different size and different kinds of scoops. So rather than always having your typical measuring scoop out, putting like a scoop like this, because they are having to use their wrist in a different way. And then I have these star pans, and then I found like some random mini erasers and some more of these little flag picks, because they could fill up the pan and then put the mini erasers in and put the little flag picks in. They could make little cakes. And if you don't have these, you could put in like a cupcake pan would work. And then sometimes putting in a big bottle is fun. I know it sounds silly, but it's harder to fill up than this, because if you look, the top's a little bit skinnier. So they kind of have to problem solve and concentrate a little bit more to fill this all the way to the top. And they have to figure out which tool should they use to fill this up. Because this big measuring scoop it's all just gonna kind of fall out the side. So they'll have to figure out that they need to use a smaller scoop and get all the little things out of the way, and they can scoop it in. So yeah, so just a fun, easy peasy sensory bin. And I keep all of my dry sensory materials. So if you dye some rice and didn't save it, I just always put it in a, those like gigantic, I think they're like 3 or 5 gallon baggies. And then I save it for the next year, and then I have it next time. So yeah, sometimes you have to end up making a little bit more, because you know, things just magically fly out of the table sometimes at the sensory table, I feel like. So for art, you can make a poppy flower field. So this one's just a super open-ended art activity. So just a paintbrush. Whoops, great. Old enough to wipe that off on my picture, because I didn't bring a napkin over here. Super. we're just gonna go with roll with the punches. So they can just cover and paint. You can put out different size paintbrushes, so they can just have fun exploring. I put out some glitter, so they can put some glitter on, and then what they'll probably do is paint more. So give it a kind of like a fun texture. And then to make the poppies, all you do is I would literally put these little tissue paper squares in a cup, and you can tell like I cut them. They are not perfect squares. So I just took some red tissue paper, cut it up in some chunks, and then what they do is they're gonna crumble it up and use some glue, which I don't have a glue bottle out here, but we'll pretend I have glue, and then they can put it in their field. So it's a really fun open-ended art activity. Some kids, they'll be covered in paint. Other kids will have some that'll have just a little bit. But again, just a fun, open exploration art. And again, just put in some different size paintbrushes so they can explore that too. And the glitter to make it a little bit of texture. If you don't like glitter and you don't want to use glitter in your classroom, that is okay. No worries. What you could do is maybe put out or put a little bit of salt in your paint or a little bit of flour just to kind of give it a different texture as they're painting their picture. And it would kind of look more like grass if it's kind of a little bit bumpier or spikier. So yeah, so in a little cute little poppy field. And then here is the fun freebie that I'm gonna send you guys tomorrow. So again, go to the top of this post, sign up for the newsletter, and you'll get this freebie tomorrow. So what it is, it's just a flag, it's just a printable, but you could use this so many different ways. One way is you could put out paint sticks and they could paint or color it in. They could just color it in with markers. They could do that too. You could put out just like red, blue, and white, and silver paint, and they could paint the flag. You could also make it into a cutting activity, and you could just put out a whole bunch of strips of paper. I did yellow for the stars. So what they would do to practice cutting would be, oh, I forgot to put the white strips out. Oops. They would just take their strip and they would cut it. And then they would glue the little squares on the stripes. And what I would do is I would put a real flag at the table too, so that way they kind of know what it looks like, and they would also be working on patterns. And then they could do the blue and they could put that on and cut and put that on that part. Or if you don't want to do cutting, that's totally fine. You could also do like a tissue paper collage. So what they do is you can either cut the squares smaller, or they put the glue on and then they crumble up the tissue paper, and then they can put it on to make the stripes. So yeah, just cut up some blue and some red, and you can even cut up white. So they could put white there and they could cover the whole thing with tissue paper. That is a little bit tricky. That's a lot of space to cover. So if you have littles, I would maybe, I would just cut up your squares a little bit smaller. And you guys, this is how fancy I am. Like, this is how, if I need smaller tissue paper squares, like, this is what I do. Like, I just cut them. Like, the kids don't know that they don't have to be perfect. So that way they don't have to crumble them, because that would take a long time to fill. So they can just put the tissue paper squares in the rectangle, and then they could fill it in that way. So it wouldn't be so frustrating, because sometimes, especially like three-year-olds, if something takes a really long time and a lot of fine motor, it can be frustrating. So they can just fill it in that way and then put some blue on this part, or just kind of put it wherever, whatever they want to do, right? So that's another fun idea. And again, I will send you guys this printable tomorrow in the newsletter, so make sure you guys are signed up for that. And then if you guys have my counting stews, this is the counting stew for the USA. It's the USA stew. So it's basically a super, super fun counting game. So they pick a recipe card. I'm gonna pick one that has a lower number. So they would take one eagle, and this one does come with a printable eagle because that's kind of hard to find for a manipulative. Three stripes, and I just cut up some foam paper, 1, 2, 3, and then 5 coins. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then they mix it up, and then they start it again. It's so much fun. I know a lot of people did the witch's brew for Halloween, and that was a really fun counting stew. And then this one also has fireworks, so they can put the fireworks in the stew, which is just, I just make those with pipe cleaners, and then stars, which these are just some foam stars I had. So you can put your counting stew out for Veterans Day. So that's another fun idea. Now, if you need manipulatives for this theme, I know it can be kind of tricky, But again, I'm gonna give you some ideas. So you can just use pom-poms. So you can use white pom-poms, blue pom-poms, and red pom-poms. Hobby Lobby has the pom-poms in the bags, and they're like a dollar a piece or something. And then you could also use just glass gems. I know the blue gems and the white gems are usually at the Dollar Tree. I bought these 1 year at the Dollar Tree during Valentine's Day, I think. But you can also take these and spray paint them red if you wanted, or you can just use these with some red pom-poms. That works too. Do whatever works for you. And then, oh, another game you could play with the plates. And then you could also use these as counters too. Your little flags. Let me grab a plate. So another game that you could do with the plates again. I move these over here. You could just give everybody a star and a plate and put out some manipulatives in the middle of the table and they just roll the dice. I got two and they have to get out two. One, two, and they have to put it on their plate. Super, super simple. Again, you can just put out different colored dice and just grab them. If you don't have those, you can grab just the cubes that are red, white, and blue. It doesn't have to be super, super fancy. So roll the dice and put that money on. I do love plates. You can use them for so many different games. Okay. All right. So you can also put out like a card making station in your writing center. So I have a math and literacy centers unit in my TpT store. It's just called America. I think I changed it to USA. Sorry. So it's really USA. I just didn't reprint the cover. But it's a whole bunch of math and literacy centers. And again, you can use these for Veterans Day when it's voting time and or election time and 4th of July or President's Day. So these centers work great for all of those themes. And especially since sometimes you don't do these for a long time. It's just a couple activities for that day. That's perfect because you can use them for all those holidays. So what you would do is just grab some stickers. And if you guys don't have patriotic stickers, no worries, just put out some blue and red dot stickers and that will work well. Put out some dot markers, that's always a fun way to decorate the cards. And then you can put out some word cards. There is themed writing paper in here. Here's one of them, it just has some stars on it. Or you can just put out just some blank colored paper with all of the words. If you haven't downloaded this recently, I did add, I forgot one of the armed forces when I originally did it, but they're all added now. So if you haven't downloaded it in a couple years, go download it again because all of them are there now. So, and then they can make the card and try and write some of the things or make cards for the veterans in your area. And you guys, it doesn't have to be perfect. It can be scribbles and just some random words and some stickers, and that would be amazing. Super fun cards for some super amazing veterans. Another thing you can do with the word cards is build words. So you could build them on dry erase boards, and they could write the words with a dry erase marker. So that could literally be your table time activity. And these word cards, they come in uppercase and they come in lowercase. So you pick the ones that work for you. You could literally just spread these all over the table and they pick a word and then they write it. Or you could make the words with magnet letters. So give everybody a cookie sheet and put the magnet letters in the middle of the table with the word cards and they can just build all of the different words. And you can, if you wanted to, you could just print the pages that are the armed service members or our veterans, like the pages that pertain to that holiday. You could just print those out so you don't have all of them. So you could do that. And then this is a fun, this comes with a worksheet. So these are some letter trace cards. And again, there's the worksheet. So here they are. So it's just dotted letters and they trace the letter with a dry erase marker, which I can't reach right now. So they'll just trace it and then they can erase. And then And I included all of the different areas, or all the different veterans on these cards. So tons and tons of them. And then I have some are girls, some are boys, so they're diverse, so it's great. And then if you don't want to use dry erase markers, no worries. You can also build the letters with the pom-poms, or you can build them with gems. You pick how you want to do it. Or you can do it with, oh gosh, you could do it with Play-Doh. So they roll like a Play-Doh snake and then they make the word that way. So you pick, or you can put out dry erase markers and a manipulative, or you could put out all three at the table and then the kiddos get to pick how they want to make the word. So you could do it that way. And then, and again, you can use the worksheet or you don't have to. Here is you guys know I love writing trays. This is actually just a kid plate from Target. They shake, shake, shake to erase. And then this one I have just some patriotic sprinkles. So I think I made this. I bought the red, I bought a thing of white, and I bought a thing of blue. And then I found these like little stars somewhere and I threw some of those in there. So I kind of made my own DIY patriotic sprinkle mix. You could also use sand. And then what they do is they pick a letter card like I, and then they shake, shake, shake. And then I like for them to use the pom-pom, and then they can make the letter in the writing tray. And then shake, shake, shake to erase. And then they pick another one, U. U. And again, these come in uppercase or lowercase. So fun. And then shake, shake, shake to erase. But when they use the pom-pom to write, then they're using those pincer muscles and they're making all of their fun letters in the writing tray. So that's a fun writing tray you could do. It also comes with, I know you guys love these mats, a read, build, write mat, and it comes with sight words. So you can play it two ways. And here's, I wanted to show you guys the teacher direction pages. I am working on one of my goals this year when I get caught up. Is I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna update everything to make sure the units are more, they all have like real action photos. But this one actually doesn't have an action photo, but it does still show you how you can set it up. So you can do it where they are read, build, write with just the letter, or they can do it with a sight word. So, and again, it comes with a whole bunch of sight word cards and it comes with some blank sight word cards. So that way you can write in your words if you have words that I did not include in the pack. And so they could either read E and then they could make it with the, they could build it with the manipulatives. And then they would write it at the bottom, or they can read it. And we're just gonna pretend this says was, oh look, almost. And then they would write it at the bottom. So yeah, so you pick the level that you want to do and you do it that way with your kiddos. So that is another fun activity in my center pack you can do. Oh my gosh, I have stuff on all sides of me tonight. Okay, another fun literacy activity I have in that unit are these clip cards. So they're beginning sounds. So this is G. Cereal, hot dog, gorilla. And then they would clip it with a clothespin. And if you don't want to use clothespins, they can totally just cover it with a counter. Totally up to you. But it's just a fun way to sneak in some fine motor. Clips are great for helping kiddos who are working on some scissor skills too. Getting that open and closed motion in. So yeah, just a ton of different beginning word clip cards. Okay, so this one's kind of funny, and I just want you to know, I made this game like 3 years ago. So this doesn't pertain to anything that's happened recently, and you'll see why. So I made this fun syllable game where animals take over the White House. Yes, again, I made this game like 3 years ago. So they have to say the word fish, fish, and clap it, and then they have to put that animal in the White House. and let me find one. Giraffe. And then they have to put it in the White House. Lobster. Put it in the White House. Kangaroo. Kangaroo. You can have them tap the table. Kangaroo. They can hum it. Hmm, hmm, hmm. And they can put it in the house. Armadillo. Armadillo. And then they can put it in the house. And again, if they don't recognize the number, they can count the flags. So this is a really fun game. My kiddos, they went bananas over this game when we played it together in class. They just thought it was so funny that the animals were all taking over the White House. And then for a fun shape activity, this one is just matching. So they are gonna match the shapes and they're, let me see if I can find one that matches. So here's like oval with an oval. Here's one that matches. Triangle and a triangle. And you can tell there's a bunch of shapes in here. There's a rhombus and a crescent moon and octagons and all the things. So there's a ton of shapes. So you can put out the tricky shapes or you can put out the simple shapes or you can put out all of them. So again, you pick what you wanna do. This is a fun table time activity to work on 2D shapes. You could also too put out a dry erase marker with this and then they can trace that shape with the dry erase marker. That's another fun idea you can use, or you could do the worksheet with it. Here's a fun 10 frame game. So it goes all the way up to 20. So that we have up to you, which cards you put out. If your kids are only working on numbers 1 to 10, just put out those. If they're working on higher numbers, then you can put out those. And again, you can use any manipulative you want. You can use the flags. You pick which manipulative you want to use for your kiddos or what you have in your classroom. And they save the number and then they count out that many objects and fill in the 10 frame. You can also, if you're kinder, they can write the number word 2 with a dry erase marker, or they can finger trace it. So that is a fun activity to work on one-to-one correspondence. And the last activity I have is, this one is with American symbols and it's just making different patterns. So they would have to fill in the end of the pattern with the cards. And you can put Velcro on the end of these if you want to, you don't have to. And then there are also blank ones. So that way if you wanted to put out your manipulatives and they could make patterns with what you have in your classroom. And again, if you don't have this, totally fine. Just put out your manipulatives and you can put out just long strips of paper and then your kiddos can make patterns with your manipulatives on the strip of paper. So it's another fun one. And then I also wanted to say you could, for music and movement, you guys could practice the Pledge of Allegiance if that isn't something you do normally. There's also books that go through and have the words to the Pledge of Allegiance, so that would be great. I have a book list on my blog with tons of great books for this theme, so if you want to check that out, go to the top of this post and search USA books and you'll find all of those. And then for the block center, which I know can be challenging for some themes. So what you can do is go to the Dollar Tree. I would actually cut these and they can build with those like flowers, or and you can put like a little bucket of American flags in your block center. And then you can also put out some, you can get some beads, like those necklace beads, and just cut them so they're like a long strip and you can do red, white, and blue, and they can kind of decorate their buildings with those. And then I also have in my store some symbols, like they could build the flag or they could build the White House or the arch, just some USA landmarks. So different things they could build for some fun challenges in the block center or for your STEM. So, oh, and these are in the summer STEM I Can Build pack. just so you know. All right. All right. So I hope you guys got a ton of ideas for, and straws. You can also put the like pretty straws in the block center because sometimes those tall straws are really fun to build with too. So I hope you guys got some fun ideas and I hope you guys have an amazing night.